for now, guys. I will speak us through our session for the day. So quite a big chipper conditioning piece for our Metcon today. It's going to have a 35-minute time cap on it. Going to be a little bit different for everybody depending on the kit we've got as usual. So I'll go over all the movements and different standards and scales and stuff as we get closer to that. We've got a general warm-up, a little bit of mobility, and then something a little bit more specific to our Metcon to get through. And then just crack on straight with that, okay? So our general warm-up is going to be pretty short and sweet. It's going to be 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off between two movements on high knees and then air squats, okay? So increasing intensity as we go through it. Our high knees will go for 30 seconds. Let's really try and focus on getting the knees up towards the hips, if not a little bit more than that, staying on the balls of the feet. Then we've got 30 seconds rest, so I want you to go for that quite hard, okay? Not necessarily full effort. 30 seconds, quite high intensity. 30 seconds rest, and then we go on to air squats for 30 seconds, keeping the chest up, down the parallel, and then up. Pretty good at them. We're going to do three each, okay, on each of those movements, then we'll do a little bit of mobility and get going through that, okay? I will join you on this. So get yourself in a bit of a space. We start off with 30 seconds on. Nice, what's that? What was it, a picture? You're like... 30 seconds on high knees, 10 seconds and we'll get going. High knees. Rest up. 30 seconds off, then we go for air squats. Rest up. Can you get ready for our knees? 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Thanks, guys. Okay, guys, we'll do that once more. Okay, last air squats for the warm up. 3, 2, 1. Right, okay, so next little bit, we're going to lower the pace and go for a bit of mobility. So we'll all do this at the same time. We're going to do 5 each side on world's greatest stretch. So come down with me into a kneeling position. You're going to go hip to hand. And then you're going to come underneath, if you've got your left foot out, you're going to put underneath the opposite arm and stretch it. Hold it a couple of seconds. We're going to do 5 of these per side, just feeling how fine it is. Reach through as much rotation as you can for a couple of seconds. As much rotation as you can. So last little bit, we're going to just do specific stuff to our workout and then I'll go over the structure of it. 2 sets, we are going to do 30 seconds of skipping. So whether you've got a skipping rope or you do double taps, it's completely up to yourself. Main thing here is just warm up the calves and the ankles because we've got a lot of either running or a lot of kind of high impact stuff coming up in Metcon. Once you've done 30 seconds of that, you're going to go into 10 weighted squats, okay? Doesn't have to be mega heavy, it can be anything. If you don't have anything that you feel comfortable doing, then just go for square squats again. Goblet squats, on the back, whatever that may be, we're going to go for 10, and just try and use it as a bit of mobility as well at the bottom to warm up, okay? So, I'll put the clock on for 30 seconds. I don't know if you'll be able to see that. I'll try and keep your eye on it. But we're all going to come off at different times. Okay, 10 seconds, and I'll count the first 30 seconds. So focus on staying on the balls of the feet. 2, 1. Okay, let's go. Okay, good. We've got our 10 weighted squats now. Doesn't have to be too heavy. Nice and controlled. Okay, good. Nice, guys. I'll count us in for this one. It'll save us 7 o'clock set up. So 10 seconds and we're ready for our last set of skipping. Three, two, one. Let's go. Last 10 squats and then I'll go to the mid one. Right, okay. If you want to have your phone or a piece of paper or something ready, it's not too difficult. I'll just speak you through the kind of structure that we're going to do on the metcon. Cool. Right. So we are going to have a 35-minute time cap on the metcon, okay? It starts off with one of the following. A 2 kilometer run, row, bike, or ski. I'm assuming not very many people have ski ergs sitting up in their living room. So, in replacement of that, we have got 2 minutes on different stations, okay? And I'm gonna time you for the first one. So we've got 8 minutes of movement to replicate your 2K run, bike, row, whatever that may be, okay? It is 2 minutes of speed skater hops, straight into 2 minutes of burpees, straight into 2 minutes of jumping lunges, into 2 minutes knee to chest on the floor, which is not something we've done a lot of, so I'll go over all those movements closer to the time, okay? So that is in replacement of your 2 kilometers. It is 2 minutes on each. Speed skater hops, burpees, jumping lunges, and then knee to chest. Straight into 70 single arm thrusters. Straight into 70 weighted lunges. And then you finish off with your 2 kilometer row, bike, ski, or the exact same stations that we just went through at the beginning there as well. Okay, so it ends back on our 2 minutes of speed skater hops, burpees, jumping lunges, knee to chest. Okay, does that make sense structure-wise? Anybody need me to go through it again? All good? Cool. Awesome. Right, movement-wise. Helen, are you going row, I assume? Yeah. Cool. So movement-wise, if we're replacing our 2 kilometers, it's going to be 8 minutes of work. And the idea is that we keep on moving through that as much as possible, okay? So think about how you would pace a 2 kilometer run, or maybe a little bit more than that. You got 4 kilometers here in total, okay? So it's a proper chipper-style workout. It's not designed for these stations to go max effort. Unless it feels really, really good, in which case we can up the pace a little bit, okay? It starts off with 2 minutes of speed skater hops, which we've done a fair amount of. It's hard to keep a standard on these just because you don't know how far you're jumping, okay? So if you can give yourself markers, great. If not, what I want you to really focus on is loading up that front foot as we land. Okay, so we come across, we're kind of chest down a little bit, our core's nice and tight, we're landing soft on that leg, popping across, backwards and forward. Okay, so try and give yourself a target to go to on that. I know it's hard when you get tired. Then we've got 2 minutes of burpees, which you're all fantastic at. Chest knit to the ground, make sure we're coming all the way up to full extension. 2 minutes of jumping lunges. Okay, even saying that sentence makes me scared, but we'll try and keep on moving on them. Then we've got knees to chest, okay, and that's going to be on the floor into a hold position almost, and we're going to try and bring our knees up to our chest every single time, okay? You might need something, a mat, cushion, something that's quite hard on the lower back there, okay? So let's just run through them together, just a couple of reps on each, especially these knees to chest, just because we've not done a lot of them. So let's go for four of each, four speed scare hops, four burpees, four jumping lunges, and then a few of these knees to chest. See, I like how everybody's preparing. Windows are getting opened, clothes are getting taken off. It's good. Yep, good. And then let's see four burpees. Just to warm up the chest a little bit more. Lovely. Good. Okay, then we go on to four jumping lunges. So let's try and control our knee to the ground on this instead of letting it kind of thud uncontrollably, chest up. Lovely. Cool. And if you haven't practiced them already, let's go onto the ground in that slight hollow position and practice our knee to chest. It's quite tough on the lower back, so you can use your arms with a bit of momentum. You can have them by your side, have them behind your head, whatever feels good. A lot on the core, this one. Good. Perfect. Okay. Now, once we've done that, our 2 minute station on that, we've got our 70 single arm thrusters and 70 weighted lunges. Okay. Movements we've done quite a lot of, so I'm happy enough. But if we just get our objects ready and show me a couple of reps, want the reps to be split evenly on this. Okay. So if we have 35 reps on one, 35 reps on the other, basically. Okay. So your single arm thrusters, if it's too heavy, if you've got, say, your dumbbell, your object is too heavy, then of course you can go double arm. Okay, just do the exact same amount of reps. Okay, it depends. Obviously, it's going to change depending on the objects that you got there. Okay, weighted lunges are the exact same. Okay, we could be going single arm into that front rack position where we do 35, we're holding it on one side, and then the opposite, equally, it can be in a goblet position if it's very, very heavy and you find your core giving out. Then it can be back rack as well. And then we finish off back on to our kind of cardio stations or 2K. Questions?
Did you say, is it thrusters or lunges or is it both?
It's both, yeah. So it's meant to be, is it wall balls and waiters, carry? Suitcase lift for the programming, but obviously it's meant to be 400 meters, so not, that'd be a lot of walking in the living room.
Yeah.
So, yeah, 70 single arm thrusters and 70 weighted lunges. Yep, leg central today. Leg central, like your 2 seconds. Okay, I'm going to do it with you, so apologies if you hear me breathing really loudly. I will keep you right on the first bit, okay, so your 2K replacement, you've got 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 2 minutes. Obviously, we're all going to be getting off of our thrusters and weighted lunges at different points, guys, so if you can have your clock there ready for once you get done these weighted lunges, then you can have your 2 minute station ready to go. If people are starting at the same time as me, I'll shout it out still, so... we can keep some sort of structure to it, but have your clock there just in case. Good.
wanted you to be doing the chair rubber band pull.
Remember?
I'm so sorry to disappoint you. That was a once in a lifetime. Oh,
that was great.
I know we are fun today.
Oh dear. Right, let's get ready to go. Okay, so we're starting off on 2K. The first station, our 2 minutes, is going to be speed skater hops. So I'll keep you right on the first one. 10 seconds, we're going to get going. 2 minutes of movement. 2, 1, let's go, nice and steady. Let's try and get nice and warm on that front leg. Okay, bar feeds, let's go. Let's keep moving. Jumping lunges, let's go. Okay. Go on, guys, stick with it. Okay, on the floor, knees and chest. Got 50 seconds left on this. Then we go think get thrusters right.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Definitely.
guys. Come on, guys, we're getting there. Try and find that page so you keep on moving. Go on.
You.
Go on, guys. Keep going. Go on, try and move on, we're almost there. Continue. Let's go, keep on pushing. Well done. Go on, guys. Go on, Helen. Nice pulls, keep it going. Awesome, go on. Come on, big drive out those legs, stick with it. You. 26:37. Nice, guys. Good effort. Well done. Awesome.